Raymond Dart's experience in the World War may have colored his interpretation of what these bones and teeth meant. You know, it gave him a view of sort of the dark side of humanity and the violence of humanity. And he came up with this idea that Australopithecus had figured out that bones and teeth were hard and could be used as weapons to kill other animals. This sort of killer ape theory of early humans.
In the 1950s, there was a drama critic and playwright named Robert Ardrey, who became very interested in human origins. And he went to Africa and spoke with Raymond Dart, and Robert Ardrey, being a dramatist, could write like anything, and he wrote this amazing book published in 1961 called African Genesis.
African Genesis became a pop science publishing sensation of the early 1960s.
One of Robert Ardrey's greatest fans was the filmmaker Stanley Kubrick. At the time, he was planning a film based on the science fiction novel 2001, A Space Odyssey. At the beginning of the film, our ancestors discover the first technology.
And so this sets up then for Kubrick the same conflict that Dart felt. For Dart, that first weapon explained the emergence of human beings, while at the same time, it explained the atrocities of the 20th century.
Whether they were so-called killer apes or not can be seen in what they ate. Amanda can see what Sidibe was eating when she discovers phytoliths, the microscopic remains of plants.
Well, this is a phytolith that we recovered from the calculus of the Sidibe individuals. And we have a couple of examples here, all from different plants that this individual ate. All the evidence suggests that the foods that this individual was eating were coming from closed forested regions. So eating fruits, maybe chewing on stems, eating the grasses that are growing in that area.
There's little to back up Raymond Dart's theory that they were killer apes.
So our ancestors, or the early hominins in South Africa, were the victims rather than being the carnivores that Raymond Dart wanted them to be.
It seems Raymond Dart's vision of our ancestors as the first killer apes, so famously portrayed by Stanley Kubrick, was wrong. Many scientists now believe that a key element of that transition was the growth of ever stronger cooperation and social bonds.
Early humans had to evolve cooperation in order to survive here. We didn't have big canines and sharp claws. We just had each other.